I'm up here because, for many reasons, but one is because I'm a teacher. I work with preschool children, and I'm really concerned about their future. You know, I might be, with a little luck, I might be around another 3 decades or so, and maybe things won't get too horrendous in that time, although they very well might, but I'm really scared for these kids, this next generation that's coming up, because we got to do something about the climate, we got to get rid of these arsenals of nuclear weapons, got to get away from nuclear power, we got to get away from this whole way of thinking.
I'm against basically everything George Bush is doing. I'm completely against the war in Iraq and feel that we should, like my friend Tom was saying, take care of the environment, take care of education, we should have health care for all Americans, like all the other civilized countries in the world, supposedly.
Just in his brief first term in Congress, an excellent representative for Connecticut. And I don't think he should be replaced by somebody that Bush comes to raise money for.
I think it's ridiculous that people would pay $10,000 to have their pictures taken with two of these men who have caused so much despair in the world. And that in the meantime, there are hungry people, that there are people who need medical attention they can't afford, that there are people with brilliant minds who should be afforded the opportunity to have an education. And I think there are better causes where that money should be directed.
We really think that George Bush, who was born in the town that I come from, New Haven, should stay out of Connecticut, because Connecticut is opposed to this war. The vast majority of people here are opposed to a war that he continues to build and defend. And we also, I think, many of us remember Henry Kissinger's contribution to the empire in Southeast Asia, in Chile, with thousands, if not millions, of people dead as a result of his activities. So they're two birds of a feather. Certainly Bush, we'd like to stay out of Connecticut. It would be nice if Henry Kissinger went somewhere else, too.
I just want to know how you feel about Bush being up here today.
Well, obviously I'm against him coming this way and protesting the war in Iraq, calling for an immediate end. But I think, in addition, the fact that he came to Hartford on malaria education, I think it was, and there hasn't been anybody with a malaria in Connecticut other than a world traveler.
Is there a big problem with malaria?
No, not especially the north end of Hartford. It doesn't seem to be a problem, you know. There's some other ones that are a lot larger. So I think that was just an excuse to get out here on the taxpayer's dime so that he could support the Republican candidate that's running for the congressional seat. And, you know, I don't, as a taxpayer, don't particularly want to support that guy and see my money going to support him under the guise of anti-malaria education.
Okay, and what, Jim Dean here from Democracy for America. I just want to get your opinions on George Bush coming up here to Kent today.
Well, you know, first, I'm grateful that Chris Murphy is our congressman, and I'm grateful that he's standing up to George Bush, and I'm really grateful that all of us have come out here today to let the president know where the rest of this country and where everybody in Connecticut is on the war. And I think the voters are going to have a very clear-cut choice, which is why Chris Murphy, again, will get elected to Congress. But more importantly, you know, it's It's about a culture of activism versus a culture of incumbency. If we're really going to get our troops home, we need everybody that's here and a lot of other folks here in Connecticut to keep pushing, not just Chris, but all of our other elected officials to get our troops out of Iraq and health care for every American and all of those other issues that are important to us.
And George Bush and Henry Kissinger think that just because they keep us 2 miles away, that we're not going to know that they're here, that Connecticut's not going to know that they're here, taking blood money to try to elect another rubber stamp Congress member. It ain't going to happen. No!
Here's what I think about Cappiello coming here, getting the, having this fundraiser with Henry Kissinger and George W. Bush, is that you're known by the company you keep.
I don't know what David Cappiello's smoking in order to think that taking blood money for George Bush is going to help him in Connecticut's 5th Congressional District.